I'm going to use the empirical rule to find the interval that contains 68% of the data and 95% of the data. For this example, I'm working with IQ scores. So for example, IQ scores are bell-shaped with a mean of 100 and a standard deviation of 15. So I'm going to use that empirical rule. The empirical rule is also called the 68-95-99.7 rule. And that's because it says, reading from the center out for bell-shaped data, 68% of the values are captured within one standard deviation of the mean, 95% of the values are captured within two standard deviations of the mean, and 99.7% of the values lie within three standard deviations of the mean. So I find it helpful to sketch a bell, sketch what's given, and forgive me, I'm not an artist. And for this example, the mean was 100. So if I go out one standard deviation away from the mean, remember one standard deviation is 15, so it's the mean plus 15, this value will be 115. If I go one standard deviation below the mean, to the left, 100 minus one standard deviation is 85. So the empirical rule says that 68% of the values are captured between or within one standard deviation of the mean. So if I were to shade the area under the bell curve between 85 and 115, I will have captured or shaded 68% of the values. If I go out one more standard deviation, in other words, if I add one more standard deviation to the right, I'm at 130. And if I subtract another standard deviation going to the left, I'm at 60. So, I'm at 60. Ugh, I'm a little tired today. So the empirical rule says that 95% of the values are captured between two standard deviations of the mean. So in notation, I have x bar plus or minus s. Okay, that's the interval for one standard deviation from the mean. So that would be 100 plus or minus 15. So that gives me the interval from 85 up to 115 using interval notation. If I go out one more standard deviation, or the mean plus or minus two standard deviations, that would translate to 100 plus or minus 2 times 15, or 100 plus or minus 30. Okay, so that goes down from 70 up to 130. So I did make a mistake up here. Again, I apologize. I am just very, very tired today. Okay, so my mistakes are common mistakes. All right. And then if I wanted to, I could go out one more standard deviation. Going out one more standard deviation is practically the whole thing. So that would be x bar plus or minus three standard deviations. So that's going to be 100 plus or minus 3 times 15. Okay, so that's going to go down from 55 up to 145. So on my bell curve, this value would be 145, and then we would go down to 55. So the empirical rule says that I would have captured 99.7% of the values.